asked me what I might do with her. And I told him I loved her. And he said, she doesn't have what I have. And I said, that does not matter. He said, I can show you a good time. And I said, but I know what a good time is. And I don't need a dick for that. He said, I said, bitch, I can show you a good time. Either she dies, or you give me a shack. And I'm sure you two would be caught between a rock and a hard place. And I thought, death, or a meaningless fuck. I love a dwarf. I want to tie you on the bed and I want you to scream her name while I'm fucking you, because that turns me on. I thought to myself, how sick is he? Really, how sick is he that I can fuck him and scream my baby's name while at it? And you're quiet. And he said, think about it. Think about it real hard. And I sat and I thought about it. And then what kept on resonating in my mind is death or meaningless fuck. And I thought to myself, but I love her. I love her too much. I can't lose her. I can't be without her. I mean, as fuck it is. And he said, are you ready, ho? Are you ready, you lesbian fucking ho? And I said, do what you need to and let me the fuck out of here. And he went in and he said, it turns him on that if he beats the shit out of me, the fact that I'll be crying and screaming and thinking about her turns him on. And I said, do whatever you want to do with me, as long as you can kill my baby. And he grabbed me, and he slapped me. And he slapped me real hard. And he said, you guys use toys, I've got carrots. Do you want carrot? And I just kept quiet. And it's like, you're not any different to a fucking vegetarian. I want to give you meat today, since you're used to vegetables. I'll spice it up with the carrot, if you don't mind. And I said, just do your shit and let me out of here. And he took me in. He fucked me like a porn star. And he fucked me like a fucking porn star. And I kept on screaming, baby, because he said I'm a scream baby. And then while he was at it, he said, I know they use bottles too. Would you like a Savannah or a Hunter's Gold? And then I said, like I said, fuck me and let me go. And he said, do you want it in the ass as well? I said, do what you can, do what you want, do what you will, but just fuck me and let me get out of here. All he wanted to do. He made me suck his dirty, slimy, white fucking sperms. And then the death he spoke about, I wish he'd put down on me. But then again, I wanted to live for her. I wanted to live for her because she loved me. And I don't think she could bear the thought of being without me. Like, I can't bear the thought of being without her. And he fucked me. He fucked me so bad. And the only thing that I thought of was her. If she were here right in front of me or right next to me, how would she feel? Would she wish death upon herself? And he fucked me the whole night. He tied me. He fucked me in the ass. And yes, he used that Savannah bottle. And now, I was fucked by a guy who was HIV positive. And because I couldn't go to the clinic the next morning because I could barely walk, I was fucked in the ass. And in my precious temple. And the sad thing is, I still can't tell her what happened that night. I still can't tell her that her life would have been lost, and this is what I had to take for her. Because she'd hate herself. I hate me. And somehow, I hate her because I am here because she was supposed to be dead. But I love her. I do. And I hope one day I can be able to tell her that I got fucked to save her life.